Hey everyone, welcome on Davis Tech. So in this video, we are going to make the connection between the front end and the back end. So here, if you see, when we use a socket IO, then we have to use two things. In a front end side, we have to use the socket IO client, and in the back end side, we have to use the socket IO server. Okay. So for the Flutter, we are going to use a socket IO client version 0.9.12. Okay. So let me use that package, and to use that package, I have to go on a postfix.yaml file and have to place this thing. Okay. So after placing this thing on under the dependency tab, you have to hit the control S and Flutter pubget will be run. And this dependency will be installed on your project. After doing that, what you have to do that you have to go inside the Android folder. Okay, inside the Android folder, then go on app folder, and inside the app folder, go on source folder. Inside the source folder, you have a main folder, and inside the main folder, you will get an Android mainfix.xml file. Inside the Android mainfix.xml file, under the application tab, you have to place this code. This particular code you have to place, then only your socket IO will be work. Otherwise, you will face any difficulty. I faced that, that's why I'm just explaining all the thing here. Okay, so I will provide this code on a description. Please use that code. Okay, after doing these two things, what you have to do that you have to go on where you wanted to implement the socket IO client. So if I will open my WhatsApp clone, then we want to invoke the socket IO client inside the individual chat page only. So here, when we open this individual chat page, then we will create a socket IO client, and then we will connect those socket IO client to the socket IO server. Okay, so that's why we have to place the socket IO client code inside the individual chat page. So I have opened this socket I have opened the individual chat page here, and I'm going to create an instance of the socket IO client only here. So to create an instance of the socket IO client, what I will do that I'm just how to import the socket IO first. So let me go on installing and let me import this socket IO client on the individual chat page. Okay, I will import as the IO. Okay, after importing the socket IO client, what you have to do that in a state class, go and create a instance of this socket IO client with help of this io.socket. So the name of the instance will be socket itself, and what we have to do that we have to initialize this socket variable as well. So let me create a new method that where we will initialize this socket IO thing. That will be a connect, and inside the connect we are going to write the code. To initialize this socket package, what we have to do is we have to use this socket, and with help of the IO, we are going to connect the backend. Okay, io.io, and we have to place the backend server link here. Okay, now let me write the code of the backend. So if you remember that in the very last video of the chat server development, so there we created a new Node.js project, and where we placed the code of the socket server thing. Don't worry, now onwards we are going to combine these two series, chat server development and the chat app development in a same playlist. So at the parallelly, we are going to code on a Flutter and we are going to code on a Node.js in the same video. So on that last video, we created this index.js file and we placed the code of the socket IO server. But while connecting it, I find an issue. Like if I will go on a socket IO client dependency, then this dependency only support the socket IO version 2.x. But while installing the socket IO package, we install the socket IO 3.x version on this Node.js project. So that will create an issue while connecting the Flutter project to the Node.js project. That's why what I did, that I deleted the package.json file and package.log.json file and also the node module from here. And I'm going to install all the dependency Flazily. So let me use the npm install, and I'm going to use the socket.io version 2.3.0, which will be supported by the socket.io client. And I have to install the nodemon, and I have to install the express, and I have to hit the enter, and it will going to install the Flazily, I mean all the packages. Okay, and let me just, at this point of time, let me just do not use the CORS. I'm not going to use the CORS. Sometime it will create an issue, and let me put all the thing as it is here. So it will going to install the packages of these three things, the socket.io client 2.x and the nodemon and express.js. So here the package log.json file is created, but package.json file is not created. So let me create using the npm init. Just yes, all the thing will be yes. It will create the packet.json file, and all the dependency are added here. And in the script, we will put the dev script. Okay, after that, what I'm going to do that I'm going to go on index.json file, and I'm going to launch my app on my IP address, so we can connect our app with help of the IP address. Okay, so I'm going to launch this Node.js project on our IP address. And how to find the IP address? I'm going to use the IP config. So this is my current IP address, and I'm going to use it. So with help of the 0.0.0.0, it will launch the server on your current IP address. That's why I added that thing. Okay, and let's use that IP address in our individual chat page. In the URI, what we have to do that we have to use the HTTPP, and instead of the localhost, we have to use the IP address. Okay, and also we have to place the forward slashes. Then after that, the port number which we are running, the 5000 port. Okay, then after that, what we have to do that we have to provide a extra parameter over here. I'm going to provide an extra parameter which will be a generic type a string and dynamic. Okay, and I'm going to provide the parameter like this. The first parameter I'm going to provide the transport, and it will be have the WebSocket. We have to use the WebSocket over here, WebSocket. And the second parameter I'm going to provide, which have the auto connect, and the auto connect will be false for the safer side, because sometimes it will fail to connect automatically. That's why I am putting the auto connect false. And what I'm going to do that I'm going to connect the socket IO manually with help of this socket connect. It will connect the socket server manually with help of the socket.connect. Okay, so we are going to connect our socket client to this server, and after that, if it is connected, then what I'm going to do that I'm going to use the socket on connect method, and I'm going to just print connected over here. If I get connected to the socket server, not much we are doing right now. We are just checking that we are able to connect our Flutter socket IO client to the corresponding server or not. Okay, and we have to invoke this thing on the init state. So when we enter in the individual chat page, then automatically this connect will be invoked. So let me call this on a init state. Okay, after calling it, what I have to do that I have to go on an index, I mean the Node.js project, and I have to start the server with help of the npm run dev, because we specified the script. If we run the dev, then run the node mod index. So CORS thing we are not using, then where we are using, okay, let me delete this CORS thing and let me use the control S. Now the server is started at port number 5000. So let's check it that our app can connect the socket IO server or not. So what I'm going to do that I'm going to refresh the page. And after refreshing the page, if I will go on a dev stack, then it should respond connected, but it is not responding. So what I will do that we have one extra parameter called socket.connected, which will return a true or false if we connect the socket IO server. So let me just use the refresh again and I will go on a dev stack. Okay, it is showing false. Oh, we have an issue here. We have to use the S transports. Okay, after that, let me again refresh the page and let's see that now we are able to connect or not. Okay, we are able to connect, but it's showing the false first. But we are able to connect. Okay, so now we are able to connect. So let's test it that we can send a message from this Flutter to the socket server or not. So we have a socket.emit. With help of that, we send the message from the front end to the back end. So let me use that thing, the socket.emit. So we have to create an event. So if I will create here a test event with help of the slash test. So this is the event name which I created. This is the event name which I will create it. And on this event, I'm going to send a message, hello world. Okay. So after creating an event, what we have to do, we have to go on the backend as well. And we have to listen that event. So here in io.on connection, just after that, first thing I will console log that what is the ID of the client. So when we made the connection, then we created a socket instance. I mean, we will get the socket instance. So this thing, when it will make a connection, then automatically the socket instance will become in this socket instance. We can get that what is the ID of the client with help of the socket.id, and the socket ID has joined to console log, and we created an instance over here. I mean, we created an event over here that is a test event, and we have to listen on this event itself. So inside the io.on, what I'm going to do that I'm going to use the socket.on, and what is the event we are listening? We are listening at the event slash test. So after that, we will get a callback function. So this is the callback function, and what I'm going to do here, I'm just going to console log what message I'm getting from the front end. So this is the callback functions. So we are listening on a slash test event, which we created over here, and we are passing the hello world. So in this callback function, we will get that hello world message on the parameter. So we are listening over here. Okay. So let me just go on a front end again, and let's see that it's working fine or not. So what we have to do, we have to again refresh the page, because we are calling this connect method when we are entering on the individual chat page. To invoke this method, we have to again refresh the page and go on an individual chat page. When I will hit the enter over here, then we get the connected message, and let's see that we got the message over here or not. The only mistake I'm doing, we have to use the small c. Okay, so there is a lot of thing here going on. So you can see that here we got a message that the this is the ID of the client has joined. Okay, but we didn't got the message which we are sending from the front end. So remember, here we have to use the small c, not capital C. That's why we are not able to get this message while making the connection to the socket server. And let's debug that, why we are not getting the hello world message. So if I will go here, and instead of here, if I will place it here, and let's see that we are doing right or not. Let's do it again and refresh the page. Okay, let's refresh the page again. Let's see at this point of time we will get hello world or not. Again, I have to go here. Okay, now we got the hello world. Okay, so the purpose of this video is completed. From the next video, we are going to send the message from the front end to the back end, and with help of this send button. Right now this functionality I am not shown that how I implemented that. When we type a message over here, then this mic button will be converted on to the send button. So this thing we are going to do on a next video, and let's cheer up guys, because we are able to send the message from the front end to the back end, and the WhatsApp thing will be start from the next video. So thank you all, happy coding. Please don't forget to like and share the video, and don't forget to subscribe this channel. Tell your friend to subscribe my channel, because I need your help, I need your motivation. Thank you all, let's see on a next video.